Back in 2006, a firm based in Sydney pitched a self-watering raised garden bed on Australia's version of business reality TV series Shark Tank. Dubbed the Veggie Pod, the product makes it easy for people to grow vegetables at home. 4 years on, and the demand for veggie pods has increased. And here in the Philippines, sales are up by 100%, as COVID-19 and all the extra time it's given us encourages people to grow their own produce at home. Here's that interview with Veggie Pod's Yvonne Hui. So Yvonne, while some businesses were put on hold during this pandemic, yours was quite literally and figuratively speaking, flourishing. Now, can you tell us what's it like to launch and to grow an urban agriculture business during a pandemic?
Well, the response has been very overwhelming, to be honest. Before the lockdown started, we mainly sold our products through garden shows and bazaars, and those have been canceled, and we don't know when they will resume. But, you know, surprisingly, without any advertising, a lot of inquiries came in during the lockdown, and our sales have increased so much, mainly through word of mouth.
Okay, this is a very new business, VegPod. You know, you brought it in just last year. You launched, kicked off operations in September of 2019 and just began your online shop in October. What was business like prior when you had first started? And, you know, how has the lockdown affected sales?
Business was okay when we started. You know, it took a lot of conversations with our customers. Like I said, we sold through garden shows. So we had to educate them about what's unique about VeggiePod. And sales was okay. But because of the lockdown, I think, you know, people realized that, yes, there's value in growing your food. And they had more time in their hands. So our sales were better.
I know. And when you say better, you know, you say sales have increased by 100%. To what else do you attribute that huge jump?
I think it's partly panic about food security, you know, not having access to fresh vegetables, worrying about contamination when food is delivered to you. And like I said, people just have more time on their hands. So, you know, they take up a new hobby.
Mm-hmm. Can you talk to us about your products? How did VegPod start? You know, it's from Australia. How did it start? And what was it that got you interested in being the exclusive distributor here in the Philippines?
Okay, so VegPod started in Australia in 2009. It was invented by, you know, people who liked gardening. I mean, because Australia has a huge gardening culture. And they ran that for a few years, but it was only after they won Shark Tank Australia that it took off. So they won that in around 2016. And since then, they've expanded to many countries all over the world. In terms of the Philippines, I saw VeggiePod in an IG post of an Australian interior designer. And I've always been interested in gardening. And at that time, you know, our company was looking to bring in a product that we could sell directly to consumers because we've been focusing on B2B before. And we thought like this was a perfect fit. So we tried it out. You know, thankfully, VeggiePod Australia, they were very accommodating and they're very chill people. So the process was very smooth.
Okay. Now, can you talk to us about the gardening culture here in the Philippines?
You know, we see a lot of small-scale gardening centers or online sellers for gardening supplies, but we don't have huge gardening centers, and there are very limited, you know, sources that you could get supplies from. And that itself speaks for, you know, how unpopular urban gardening is here in the Philippines. Like when we had our Australian representative come to Manila, we had to go around and see, you know, what gardening centers are like here. And he was so surprised, like, you know, this can't be it. But it is what we have. So yeah, I think there's still a lot of education that needs to be done. And a lot more, you know, we hope that a lot more companies get on board and bring in products and make them available to the public.
Why buy a veggie pod when you can just set up your own stand and elevated, you know, elevated garden? What makes veggie pod so different?
There are a lot of advantages. So the first one is the canopy. It's the signature of VegiPod. You won't find that in any product out there in the market, whether it's here in the Philippines or overseas. And what that canopy does is it protects your plants from harsh elements like strong sun, wind. You know, we get very strong typhoons here. And if you leave your plants out in the garden in their pots, chances are, you know, the next morning they're wiped out. But the canopy protects your plants from that. And then it also protects your plants from animals. So you have, you know, birds who come and eat your plants, or stray cats, and pests, you know, caterpillars, bugs, slugs, things like that. And because of the canopy, you know, you have like a greenhouse climate inside the pod. And if you compare plants growing from a normal pot versus from a pod, the growth is like 50% more. I can't say for all the containers that you can find in the market right now, but for VegiPod, it's 100% food safe. And it's UV stabilized. So even if you leave it out in the sun for a long time, it won't get crunchy. So it will last for a long time and you don't have any toxic chemicals leaching into your vegetables. Mm-hmm. And there's also a water reservoir. So what that does is like you're less, you don't have to worry that much about, you know, water, overwatering or underwatering your plants, because there's a water reservoir under where the plants can get their water from. So if, say, you travel out of the country for 2 weeks and you know, you don't have anyone to take care of your plants, they have a water source down there. And you come back, you know, they're going to be even thriving more so when you left.
At the same time, is there drainage so you could leave it out? I mean, the rainy season is forthcoming. Yeah. Could you just leave it out there and, you know, with a reservoir and the rain could come in?
There's an overflow hole. So once you reach a certain level, water will flow automatically out of the pod. And because it's raised, you can put the basin under to collect that water and use that to water your plants again. So it saves a lot of water, actually.
Okay. Now, Yvonne, where do the actual products, these materials, where do they come from? Where are they sourced from?
So they are manufactured in factories in China, although some parts are from Australia.
Okay. So did you have any supply chain issues given the lockdown and the restrictions?
Because we brought the products in, you know, mid of last year, we didn't have any problems. And the stocks that we brought in, like it's like a whole 40-foot container. So we have enough supply.
So you have supply. Okay. Okay. Your demand has increased by 100% during the lockdown. You know, as the lockdown passes, by how much more do you expect demand to increase?
We've had a lot of repeat buyers. You know, we have someone who started with one small one and then they moved on to a bigger one and they recommended to other people and they got, you know, so I think it will be sustained, although I think it's also realistic to assume that it's not going to be as, you know, the increase won't be that much.
Mm-hmm. It's a very interesting product. And I think this pandemic has underscored the need for urban farming to fill gaps within the supply chain, to safeguard against contamination with, you know, even delivered goods. Yes. So it's great to have this, you know, this outlet in your own home to source your vegetables from. But Yvonne, is it foolproof? If you don't have a green thumb,
I don't have a green thumb, but, you know, so far my plants are all okay. Of course, I can't say it's 100% foolproof, but it solves a lot of the issues that first-time gardeners would encounter, you know? So it definitely makes it a lot easier. It takes away at least half of the issues that you'd face if you don't know anything about gardening. But I mean, of course, it's something that you still need to take care of. It's still something that you need to study. You know, different plants would have different requirements. So yeah, it makes things easier, but not 100% foolproof.
Okay, we see the awesome pictures, the thriving veggie pods. How much work needs to be put in order to get to be able to harvest a bounty from a veg pod?
Those pictures that you see, those are mostly from first-time gardeners, and they grew their vegetables from seed. For the first-time gardeners, we normally recommend that you start from growing leafy greens because they're the easiest, and the harvest time is shorter in general. So, you know, if you have good soil, if you have space that gets enough sunlight, and you water regularly for at least a week, then you're going to be okay. Of course, if you want more challenging projects, then you start, you know, planting like tomatoes, chilies, eggplants, those ones. But that would require more study. So you have to research about, you know, what nutrients they require, when you should start, you know, feeding them and things like that.
Okay, interesting. Okay, well, how deep is it? How deep is the veg pod? Can you do carrots? Can you, I mean, what are the things that newbie gardeners, I mean, apart from the easy leafy greens?
Yeah. So the good thing about veggie pod too is it's 1 foot deep. So it's deep enough to grow root crops. So carrots, radishes, potatoes, beets, you could grow in the veggie pod, no problem. As long as, you know, the weather, the season permits, because there are some vegetables that grow better in colder climates. But yeah, the veggie pod is deep enough for root crops.
Okay, so what do people get when they order a veggie pod? What necessarily, the most basic thing, what does that come with? And expectations-wise, how much can you plant in it?
Okay.
For your most basic to your biggest package.
So what we sell as veggie pod is just the container. So it's the garden bed, the canopy. It comes with a mist spray. So you just plug in a hose and you know you don't even need to open the cover to water your plants. And then optional, you could get the stand or the trolley. So that's what we sell. So veggie pod is the container garden bed with the optional stands or trolleys. The smallest pod that we have is 0.5 meter by 1 meter. If you plant leafy greens, for example, you'd be able to plant at least, you know, 15 heads of lettuce, or if you want 10 arugula, 5 lettuce, 5 something else, you could do that as well. Then after the small is the medium, which is times 2 the size of the small, so it's 1 meter by 1 meter. So you double the capacity. And the largest that we have is 2 meters by 1 meter. So, you know, 2 square meters space that you can plant a lot of vegetables in.
Okay. Talking about the Filipino market and the Filipino diet, arugula and lettuce, that's not something that you'll really see typically in a Filipino household menu. I mean, like if you go to tinola and all of those other veggie dishes, what are the things common or that the Filipinos are accustomed to in terms of cuisine that can be grown in a veg pod?
So like for us personally, my kids like sinigang. So I grow kangkong, okra in the veggie pod. And you can do that. But what we've found so far based on feedback from our customers is like they like to plant stuff that are not easily bought from the supermarket. You know, like sometimes arugula is available, but they're quite expensive. Or, you know, you want lettuce, but then you won't finish one whole pack. So if you plant it, you can just harvest what you need. So that's what we've been finding, you know.
What's the typical lifespan of a veg pod? You said that they, you know, they take sun well. How long can we expect a pod to last given, you know, all the heat, the humidity, and what that could do to the plastic that contains the veggie pod?
So just to give you an example, in Australia, the first generation pod, like I said, was produced in 2009, and they're still okay up till now. So at least 10 years for sure. And we have a free warranty for the pod for 2 years and the parts for 1 year.
Okay. Right. On a macro level, what do you think of the case for urban agriculture in the country?
I think since the COVID situation started, we've seen more push from the Department of Agriculture. Like they've been more active in their Facebook pages, pushing out, you know, tips, also giving out free seeds, doing free online seminars, and, you know, even senators, celebrities have been pushing for urban agriculture. And I think that's increasing awareness overall, and which is good. Hopefully we see it more being taught in schools, getting children involved, you know, learning how to grow their food, knowing the importance of growing your food and how healthy it is to eat vegetables. So.
Yeah, very healthy to eat vegetables. And right now, this pandemic has underscored the need to be able to source your own things from your own backyard. And so, yeah, thank you for bringing this business to the country. Yvonne Hui, the exclusive distributor of VeggiePod Philippines. Thank you.
Thank you so much.